Hi, I'm Menno Marks, developer advocate on the Google Maps API team. This is the third video in a series of four designed to show you how to get started with the Google Maps JavaScript API. In the last video, I covered getting an API key for the Google Maps JavaScript API. In this video, we'll cover using the key when loading the JavaScript API and the basics of using the Google Maps loader. The Google Maps JavaScript API is loaded using a script tag. The basic format looks like this. You can see that there are two parameters, both required if you're going to use an API key. A common mistake people make is to copy and paste this text without changing the parameters. The Maps API will not load in this case. First, replace API key with your API key, and then set the sensor to either true or false. In most cases, it will probably be false. For example, look at this. This will pass both the key and tell Google whether you are creating a map that uses a sensor to detect the location of the user. A note on the sensor parameter. You must set this to true or false, but it doesn't change the capabilities of the Maps API. If you are using a sensor, there's no additional data that you get, there's no costs associated with it, and likewise if you're not. We must collect this information to provide back to our data providers. That's the only reason we collect it. There are a few optional parameters, though, that you should be aware of. The first is a language parameter. By specifying the language parameter, you are changing the default language of the map, both the map tiles and the controls. In this example, by using JA, we change the map to Japanese. We support both left to right and right to left languages. For instance, if you chose AR for Arabic, you will see right to left. When you do this, however, you should specify dir equals RTL on the div containing any RTL text.
Lastly, we also include a libraries parameter. This is to load in the Google Maps API libraries that provide additional functionality to the API, but should only be loaded if they are required. For more information, see the libraries documentation at this URL.
That's all for this episode. In the next episode, we'll cover the basic maps options used to create your first map.